I am glad to have with me none other than Dr. Harin Vyas. Dr. Harin is the consultant cardiologist and HOD for the non-invasive cardiology Fortis Hospital. So welcome to the show, sir. Now we all know the ECHO has its own place in the clinical cardiology, but there are few challenges as well. So I would like to know what is the place of ECHO in the assessing the right heart dynamics.
ECHO till now was mainly used for the left ventricular assessment, right. But now with the improved machines and now with the better understanding that right heart hemodynamics plays a major role in clinical practice, mm-hmm. it has become very important to assess right heart mm-hmm. structure and function in almost all patients, mm-hmm. especially in heart failure patients. Mm-hmm. And ECHO plays a very important role. Mm-hmm. We know that with the newer machines, the image quality is much better. And the newer applications allows us to assess the right heart hemodynamics in a very accurate fashion. Mm-hmm. So far, the gold standard was the right heart catheterization.
Right.
But with ECHO, if it is done within 2-3 hours of the right heart catheterization, we know that it gives us almost similar information as the right heart catheterization, mm-hmm. But at a much cheaper rate. And it is a totally non-invasive technique with no radiation. Mm-hmm. So if it is used appropriately mm-hmm. and in good hands, it can give a very good information about mm-hmm. the right heart hemodynamics mm-hmm. in most patients.
Right. So as you said, it is a non-invasive mm-hmm. and it will be economical. So what do you feel, what will be the future and the current status of ECHO in assessing the right hand heart dynamics as far as the countries like India is concerned?
In India and even in the developed countries, mm-hmm. echocardiography still remains the primary modality mm-hmm. to assess any patients with cardiac conditions. Mm-hmm. So it is the primary tool to make a diagnosis and mm-hmm. also it is useful in the prognosis. Mm-hmm. So follow-up of the patients, the mm-hmm. treatment, whether mm-hmm. the patient is responding to the treatment or is a non-responder, mm-hmm. ECHO still is the preferred method of diagnostics.
Okay. And what are your views on the correlation of right atrial pressure and the right heart dynamics?
Right atrial pressure is quite useful as it gives you the central venous pressure. Mm-hmm. It gives you the volume status of the patient. Mm-hmm. So it is a very commonly asked question whether we should give fluids to the patient or not. Mm-hmm. And that's where the ECHO comes in handy mm-hmm. to try and assess what is the right atrial pressure.
Right.
Certain surrogates like the inferior vena cava, hepatic veins can be used mm-hmm. to try and assess right atrial pressure mm-hmm. On which a physician can decide mm-hmm. the further treatment course for that patient.
Okay. So which key message you would like to give to the cardiologists and the practitioners as far as the right heart hemodynamic assessment is concerned?
Echocardiography is still the best first modality mm-hmm. to assess right heart hemodynamics. It is cheap, it is safe, and in good hands, it can reproduce same numbers mm-hmm. repeatedly.
Okay. So, sir, thank you so much for your valuable time and such a kind of nice information on the right hemodynamics. Right.
Thank you.